So we are discussing today about the femoral tunnel length and loop calculations, and when we are doing an ACL surgery, how we calculate the length of the loops that we are taking and how are we drilling the femoral tunnel. So we know that we need to drill the femoral tunnel at the anatomical location, and it has to be at the origin or at the insertion of the ACL. And what I recommend is using a marked V pin, which is marked with a pointer, and this is called as a retro gauge system. And this retro gauge V pin will allow you to measure the femoral tunnel at the first step. So what we do is this is the femoral notch, and there is a mark in this V pin, which is marked R. So you have to drill it up to the R, and then measure the length of the femoral tunnel from outside. And this is called as a retro gauge. Now this device will increase your accuracy of measurement of the femoral tunnel. Now if this length is less than 30 mm, I recommend that you don't accept it, because we need at least 50 mm of graft in the tunnel, and the least available size of the button is 15. Less than that is available, but then it is not easy to flip. So I will recommend, if it is less than 30 millimeters, you can consider revising your primary beat pin. So if your tunnel length is between 30 to 35, you use a 15 mm button. Now I will talk about adjustable loop later, but if your loop length is 30 to 35, you use a 15 mm button. If your loop length is 35 to 40, you can use either 15 or you can use 20. Okay? And if your length is more than 40, recommended to use either 20 or 25. Now we need to have a flipping distance. So your length of the bigger drill should be 7 mm less. So if supposedly your femoral length is 33 and you want to use a 15 mm button, okay, so 7 mm is a flipping distance which is must. So you deduct 8 from this, so 25. So minimum 25 mm you should drill. Okay, so 7 mm is the flipping distance for the button. Okay, same if your length is 39 and you plan to use a 20 mm button, 7 mm is the flipping distance. So 39 minus 13 is 26. So you have to drill it up to 26. Okay, so 7 mm is the flipping distance. So you minus 7 from the length of the button, and then you deduct that from the length of the tunnel, and that will give you the exact sizes. So this is when we are doing about the fixed loop button. Okay, so the most common size that you will get in Indian scenario is either 15 or 20. Okay, and thereby you will have a graft which is at least 15 mm into the tunnel. So if you are using supposedly 33 mm tunnel, you use 15 mm button, so graft inside the tunnel will be 18. Did you get it? You drill it more, it will go out, it will flip, and you will pull back. Okay? So if you use 15 mm button in a 33 mm tunnel, your graft inside the tunnel will be 18. But you need to drill it up to 25. Okay? So 7 mm is the flipping distance you need for any adjustable loop to function. Okay? Now, if you are using an adjustable loop, you just have to calculate the amount of graft that you want to be inside the tunnel. So supposedly you decide that you want your graft to be 20 millimeter into the tunnel. So your graft length is around 7 centimeters, and you got 2 centimeters inside. So here what you do is you drill 20 mm. That's it. Okay, So, and but you need to calculate the tunnel length again with the retro gauge, because this will help you to flip the button. So here, if you are using an adjustable loop, only one button size will be there, and always you will ream tunnel up to 20 or 25. You can ream up to 25. That is also fine. Okay. And finally, this whatever you drill will be filled up with the graft. So as compared to a fixed loop versus an adjustable loop will lead to a more complete filling of the tunnel. So supposedly in this scenario, if you drill it up to 25, here the graft fill is 18. Here the graft will be 25 because you have drilled the tunnel up to 25. So this is about adjustable loop. So adjustable loop, no calculations. You just have to drill the amount which you want the graft inside the tunnel. But still it is better to measure it with retro gauge because you have to mark it. The majority problem in adjustable loop comes that you don't have an idea about where to flip. And that's why you pull it harder and the button will go into the soft tissue. So that is why adjustable loop also, it is better to use a retro gauge, better to measure the tunnel total length of the femoral tunnel. So that will give you an exact indication. So what we recommend is whenever you, this is the button, this is the flipping device, so you mark it. So this is the adjustable loop button, you mark it at 4 centimeters. So if the tunnel is 40 centimeters, you mark it here. So that you know okay, here the mark is there and then you flip it. Otherwise you will flip, pull it more and there will be a, the button will be off the bone and into the soft tissue. Now Eco Button Flex, as we discussed, is a newer device. This is a hybrid loop. This has advantage of both fixed and adjustable loop. The calculations are same as the fixed loop. But what happens if you are using supposedly 20 mm button, 39 tunnel, rest everything is same. You drill 26 you drill, and then when you flip it, it will be flipped like that only. And now in a fixed loop device, the tunnel fill will be around 20. Here you can, after the flipping of the button, you can still pull the graft more. So the filling of the tunnel will be from 20 to 26. So approximately it will be like 23 or 24. So it will pull the graft more. But then after flipping of the graft, you can pull the graft more into the tunnel even after flipping the button. So it's a hybrid button. The calculations are similar to fixed loop, but you have an opportunity to shorten the loop later on. So that the advantages of the adjustable loop, complete filling of the tunnel is possible. So that is one drawback of fixed loop, which is taken care by the Eco Button Flex. So you take care of that drawback. So more complete filling of the tunnel is possible. Okay, any questions?
Sir, in Eco Button Flex, is there any chance of the graft again become lax?
So that's theoretically, that problem is with all adjustable loops. For all adjustable loops and for Eco Button Flex, theoretically, there is a loop lengthening. If the loop lengthening occurs, it may get loose. But practically, it does not happen. And if it happens in Eco Button Flex, it has only 2 to 3 millimeters of play, not more. Here the play is more, So if it is in adjustable loop, the length of the loop initially is 10 centimeters and you shorten it up to 1.5 or 2 centimeters. So you have a big loop, so big chance of losing if that is there. In Eco Button Flex, it is only minimal tensioning. So it is like 20 mm loop, which will be reduced to maybe 16 mm or 70 mm loop. So it's 2 to 3 millimeters, very small adjustability, which is there. Okay, any other questions? Clear about the calculation? Now this retrograde is better than the antigrade measurement, because in retrograde you can measure it in the first step. If you're using an antigrade, then you have to drill with the 4.5 mm reamer and then measure. And then if it is less, then it is an issue that you have to re-drill or something like that. So here, with the retro gauge, you are at the first step, you know the tunnel length, and then you can organize all of your surgeries at the first step. Okay, so this is important, 7 mm flipping distance you must know. Okay, these calculations you must know, 30 mm you must take as a least length possible for the femoral tunnel, and rest is easy. So, and if you are using a fixed loop, you should have any 15 and 20 mm button in your armamentarium. If you are using an adjustable loop, it is only one loop which is there. If you are using eco button flex, I recommend you keep 20 always or 25 maybe. So that is it. Okay. Thank you.